Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Blender tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you a cool trick we're going to do with the bevel to kind of create this effect here. It's going to be really cool for doing bottom details of a wall or something like that. So I'll just left click my object and press X and then choose delete. Then I'm going to press shift A and then under mesh I'm going to choose cube. And I'm going to press tab to go into edit mode. And we need to press 2 on the keyboard to go into edge select mode. I'll then left click the edge which I want to change. I'll hold down the control key and then press B to activate the bevel tool. And then I'll just move my mouse in order to adjust that. Once I've got to a place where I'm happy with, we can just leave it there. And we just want to concern ourselves with this menu here. So I'll come down to the bottom where it says bevel, open this up. And here we've got a whole bunch of options. We can adjust the width if we want to adjust it again, or we can change the segments, which is going to make it much smoother. I'll set the segments to 1 just now, just to explain something later. And all we need to do is come down to the bottom here where it says super ellipse and custom and change it to custom. You can see I've got a design here. I'll show you how we made this though. We'll just go ahead and left click this and reset curve. And this is what you'll be greeted with at the start. And all you need to do is just start left clicking and you can start making some adjustments here. Now, the more complex you make this design, the more cuts you're going to need in order to bring it to life, as otherwise it's going to look like a more jaggy form of what you've created here. But you can just go ahead and create a design. You can get as creative as you want with it, really. I'll come to the top here, and in order to see it, we need to add more segments because it needs more vertices to work with. So I'll go ahead and increase that, and you can see it starts off pretty jagged, but as you increase the segments, it's going to start smoothing it out to match our design here. And this can be really good for going ahead and blocking out something quite simple here, and it looks pretty damn cool. So yeah, that's just a quick cool tool which I wanted to show you today because it is super useful. Apart from that though, I hope you have a lovely rest of your day, and I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.